Hey there, Heather Ho there. Strip Code Dummy, welcome you to the ASG Golf Earlies in 2000s, the second round, as J.H. Taylor and Willie Anderson Jr. at 7-under par lead at Pebble Beach, with Kenny Perry, Ellen Robertson just one stroke behind. The cut line, remember it's top 40 in ties, excuse me, is minus one, as of right now, but remember, we're close. So you see Mike Weir at 1-over par, he's just off the cut line. So there will be 45 golfers if everything goes according to plan. So we have a normal course, strong winds. I don't know if the winds are going to be too strong for me to do this, but we will do the Stephen Ames group. I'm just thinking of something off the top of my head. I'm sorry. You have to hear that kind of. Yeah, so we're going late in the groups with the Stephen Ames group. But I think with the winds being the way they are, we probably will only see like a few holes. Darren Clark triple bogey, not good. Paul Runyon's got, he's 3-under par today. He better get some scores because minus one is the cut line with 43 golfers who will qualify. Young Tom Morris triple bogey. Well, he's starting off terribly. He's got that second place to fall back on in case things happen, but you want to win the freaking tournament, don't you? Yes, you do. Yes, you do. You do. Anyway, yeah. So, Jack Hutt. Oh, now minus one is back to being the cut line with 40 golfers. So, Paul Runyon is actually hoping that the cut line gets worse than even par. Because he wants to get in at a 467. It's like, what the fuck? I'm not going to qualify? Well, if you had a good first round, you wouldn't be in this situation now, would you? But of course, 40 out of 144. Well, ties do count, too. If you're tied for 40, if you're fine. Rough Goddard. Oh boy, his 4-under par might not be enough. Oh, 5-under par, and it might not be enough. He might miss by a stroke. Man, that's gonna hurt. Okay, back to, okay, evens back to tie for 40 if he's even par. Good. Nope. So Sergio, Cooper, and Matisse have not started their rounds, and they're at even par, one stroke off the cut line. Jack White, Alex Smith, Willie Parks Sr., and Mike Brady and Johnny Farrell have yet to start there. Jonathan Kay, 5-under par, but he's missed he's off by 2 strokes as of right now, so I wonder if Jonathan Kay is related to the entertainer Danny Kay. Danny Kay. I don't think so, but you never know. Yeah, minus one is the guideline, 42 golfers would qualify. Okay, here's Willie Park Sr. with Stephen Ames and Harold Hilton. Willie Park. Here's Ames. On the right side, okay. Wind can push him in to the right. Harold Hilton. Right side, okay. Second shot. Hilton, ooh. Bunker. Ames. Park. Up and over. Park. Maybe close. Yep. He's got something going. A lot of people said, well, Willie Park would probably play for pars, knowing that he'll be playing for the weekend. It could all go wrong for him. Ames for par. Overshot. Willie Park Sr. Wow. Aye, aye. Those wins, eh? Those wins sure whacking a wallop today. I think the winds are just telling everyone, you think you have it so easy. How about that? Willie Park? Okay. Well, Ames is giving me a bit of a headache. Mind ya. For Park. How the fuck did he fuck that up? For double. That'd be a triple. I'll have a triple, says Hilton. Aims for bogey? Park, better make this jump. Ugh. Keep going. Clock's 7 minutes. Yeah, I've only done 7 minutes of this stuff, so I might as well keep going. Nicely done by Hilton. That's going to be a bogey, I mean, birdie attempt. Oh, and Park. That's going to be a birdie to help him out. Ames, not even close. Park for birdie. Got it. Ames for Park. Hilton for birdie. Made that. Correct. Maybe this group is not all lost in themselves, if you will. If you know the saying and all that. Stuff. Park. In the middle. What? Oh boy. That wind. Sure took out. Well, about that one. Ooh, skipping. Clean. And Steve Lance does that. Really, Park? Ames teams I don't think will make the cut. Hilton, his chances are like 40% maybe? Okay, alright, he's on the green. At least he has a shot. Ames. Roll back. Roll. Fuck. Willie Park. Okay. Roberti. Roberti. Oh, he missed. Oh, for fuck's sake. Well, I've got a couple of pars. Harold Hilton. I think after the seventh, I'll stop. I'll stop. Yeah, after the seventh, because of strong winds and all that shit. Think, right? Whoa. What the fuck, Ames? What the fuck indeed? Hilton? Clean? Okay. Well, that's a chip for a birdie. Park? Oh boy, nice job by Park. Really nice shot. Ames? Ah! Aggravating. Aggravating. Just aggravating. Hilton will... I would lag if I were you. Yeah. I lag and then just lick your loons. Free you go. Got it! Willie Park Sr. is at 200 par. Hilton? And he missed the birdie putt! That was supposed to be a gimme. To make it up for birdie. Because it would have been 2 over par and then been close. Tiger's at 10 under par. He's the leader. So Tiger Woods, well, he is Tiger freaking Woods after all. Now for the postage stamp, as I call it. Park? Not bad. Could have been better, but he's on the green. Hilton. Okay. Fair enough. Steven Ames? Oh, yeah, that's good. That's very good. For birdie. Oof. Park Sr. is at 2 under par. I'm debating whether to approve or give up. I don't want to jinx him. Oh, well, at least I hit the bunker. Hilton? Yeah, I think they're all aiming for the bunker because of that wind, and Ames is just pissing me off, and that is going to be the icing on the cake. I'm going to end this group once and for all. Hilton? Alright, that's a par. I want to be your best friend. And Park will do that. Ames will do that. For double. Well, he's not going to do it. That's it. I flipped me lid. So, we'll just play it out. I'm sorry, but that's how I feel. Minus one is the cut line. And the wind's now going to the south instead of the north. Oh, the wind's died down to moderate. Okay, well, that might be okay. The cut line is fluctuating between even and minus one. Alright, top 40 and ties. 40 and ties. Like Popeye and Sun. Really? Do 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 do. So anyway, big news, of course, tomorrow not only is the third round of this tournament, that tomorrow will be a big day in the baseball Legends tournament, as four matchups, Texas, Baltimore, Oakland, Houston, Toronto, Kansas City, and Boston, Seattle, will determine the last four spots in the American League quarterfinals. The National League quarterfinals have been all set up and will be playing on Tuesday, on Monday, because they, like, no tiebreaker games came from the NL, so Monday, the NL quarterfinals will happen. Philly starts against St. Louis on Monday at 11 a.m. At 1 Eastern will be Cincy, Florida. At 6 o'clock Eastern will be Pittsburgh, Arizona. And LA San Fran will play at 10 Eastern time. Now, three of the four NL series will play on Thursday. We'll go Monday, Thursday. San Fran, LA will go Monday, Wednesday. But the other three National League matchups will go on Thursday, which will mean that there will be three American League matchups that will go Tuesday, Wednesday. We know that Detroit Yankees will start on Tuesday and play Wednesday. So they'll do a Tuesday, Wednesday. Oh, an eagle by Bill Melhorn. So, yeah. So Yankees, Tigers will be the only quarterfinal that we know about in the NL. Will go Tuesday, Wednesday. For the, and it will be best of three, as was the first round. So, yeah. So lots of matchups and all that. Cleveland and Anaheim will make it. Well, Cleveland and Anaheim also swept their opponents. But the big thing about that is that Cleveland and Anaheim both will get home games. Will have home field. Like, I would love to put Cleveland and Anaheim against each other because they both swept. J.H. Taylor, another birdie there. But because Cleveland and Anaheim swept their opponents, I decided to put them both as home teams for AL quarterfinals on Tuesday. So Cleveland will host either Oakland or Houston. By random draw, the winner of Oakland-Houston will face Cleveland. The winner of Texas-Baltimore will take on Anaheim. And the other two tiebreakers between Toronto, Kansas City, and Boston, Seattle, the winners of those two games will face each other. All right, so next round. All right, so the cut line was minus one with 41 golfers sneaking in. So young Tom Morris, Johnny Farrell, and Ari Cooper survived. Jonathan Kay, look at that. He went from 6 over to 7 under in one day. He had 2 bogeys, but man, he had 9 birdies. And Jonathan Kay's now just snuck in. What a 64. One mistake, he would have been out. Unfortunately, commiserations to Ruff Goddard, Paul Runyon, and Chris DeMarco, who had rounds of 4 under par or better, but they missed out by one stroke. Bob Ferguson missed out by one stroke. I mean, Eddie Guyke. Willie Park Jr. missed out. Jeff Ogilvie missed out by an inch. Bob Ferguson, you know, Eddie Guyke. Jerry Kelly, Jim Furyk missed out. Justin Rose by a stroke. Thomas LeVay by a stroke. And Chris DeMarco and Adam Scott both missed out by a stroke. Hmm. The unofficial worst golfer was Andres Romero, 16 over par. Steve Flesch, second at 14 over. And the third worst was KJ Choi at 13 over par. Stephen Ames finished at 9 over par, not good. Did Mike Weir make the cut? Yes, he did. Mike Weir made the cut and had a 665, so he's tied for 12. Nice. The leaders right now are Tiger Woods and J.H. Taylor. So Taylor keeps his first round lead, but Tiger Woods has tied him at 10 under par. Tied for third, one back is Kenny Perry and Jim Barnes. While tied for fifth, Phil Mickelson and Jack White. A 65 by Jack White. White, who took second place in January, he wants to win a tournament so that he can actually get rid of his runner-up finish and go to Augusta no matter what. Sergio Garcia had a 65 as well, alongside Jamie Anderson and Mike Weir with key 65. So yeah, so somehow those 65s came through. Well, for Anderson and Sergio, they needed a few under pars and Mike Weir because they would have been cut. But yeah, so that should be an interesting thing. Mike Weir is tied for 12. Nice. Unofficially, Weir is in with Percy Ellis, Peter Ellis's father. Percy qualified for Augusta, right? Yeah. He qualified for Augusta. So there's 21 groups. Well, 20, yeah. Harry Cooper is all by himself, but he will be by himself. Tiger Woods and J.H. Taylor are the final pairing on Saturday. So that'll be interesting. Anyway, I'm Jeff Diamond. Adieu.